Good morning, students and staff. Principal Swanson here with your morning announcements. Tonight is the drama club's second performance of the little-known play, Go Home, There Is No Show Tonight. We would like to remind you to please stick around for the entire performance. For some reason, last night, most of our audience left after the title was read. We would like to apologize for the strange events that led to the evacuation of the school gymnasium during last night's varsity basketball game. After a lengthy and thorough investigation, it turns out that the company that provides us with our cheer team outfits gave us gorilla costumes by mistake. We have decided that if you happen to see a gorilla or a team of gorillas, please remember, real gorillas do not carry around pom-poms. They are rarely cheerful, and they don't typically perform acrobatic stunts. Around this time last year, I told you I was setting a goal, that our football team was going to take state championship. Well, we didn't take state championship. In fact, we lost every single game. Forfeited every one. Apparently, we didn't have a football team. We forgot to assemble one. So, this year, football tryouts are today, and anyone that knows what a football is encouraged to come. If anyone is happy to see the cross-country team, please contact the office. We've been missing them for about... And if you have any information, please contact us. They went on one of their morning jobs and they never came back. On to more important business. Do you see yourself in a field of robotics in the future? Do you think you'll be able to make something great and engineer something amazing? If you said yes, please come to the principal's office immediately. There is a robot roaming around the school pretending to be me, and I demand to know who built it.
I am Principal Watson.
Hey, stop right there. Get back here. After 3 long years of dictatorship, tomorrow marks the first day at this school that we're having a student body election. I would like to personally congratulate everyone that took part in the bloodless coup that sent General Jason Gooley straight to detention, where he belongs. Peanut butter squares will no longer be served in the school cafeteria. After a very long and heated debate between the school lunchroom workers and the geometry department. But let me just say this. Some of them look like squares, and some of them look like rectangles. But they were all delicious. Thank you. Good job. attention, everyone, and I hope you have a lovely... one moment. My phone's ringing. Hello? Uh-huh. Wait, what? But how? Okay, I'll tell. Sorry for that interruption, everyone, but I have just been informed that General Booley has escaped from detention and is now taking over the student body government. That means that tomorrow's student body election has been canceled. And in its place is another loyalty march. Great to have you back, General Booley. Thank you for your attention and have a lovely day.
Now, I want you,
Miss Beaver, Tammy
just caught a fly with her tongue and ate it.
I did not.
Yeah.
I did not.
Tiny,
stop denying things.
But I didn't do it.
What did I just say? Do you want attention? Now, I want you to remove one of the pins from your kit and put into your frog's left foot.
Ow! Hold still!
Miss Beaver, she just jabbed me with a pin!
Stop moving your flipper!
I don't have flippers!
Miss Beaver, Tammy's lying to me!
Tammy, stop lying to people! I have had enough of your outbursts. You're switching my partner. Tammy, you team up with Sarah. Chrissy, you team up with Brent. I'm gonna move on. We don't have all day.
Thank you!
Now that everyone...
Miss Beaver?
Is situated.
Tammy just passed me a note saying let's release all the frogs.
I did not.
Did too.
Did not,
Tammy.
I just switched lab partners. How could I possibly have the time to write a note, let alone pass it?
Are you questioning my understanding of time? I was learning time back when you was in kindergarten.
Well, I was learning about time back when I was in kindergarten too, so...
Ooh, that does it.
Oh, come on, Miss Beaver. Sarah, do you see me writing a note?
I'm trying to learn. I'm not paying attention to your antics.
What? Antics? You go wait in the hall until class is over.
This is ridiculous.
Miss Beaver, may I release my frog too?
I'm not a frog, you idiot!
Out! Lovely, wonderful students. And then I'm not equal to the sum of the areas of the squares the size of the two legs.
No, it's not.
Well, there you have it, class. A squared plus B squared does, in fact, equal C squared. Class dismissed.
But there's still 45 minutes left.
I said, class dismissed.
Raise your hand! I assume you're talking about if the vehicle is already moving is not the correct answer. Now, did somebody here correctly tell me what to do at a stoplight? You
stop?
Wrong! My gosh, how do you get by in the world? At a stoplight, you first need to evaluate your situation. You must determine what color the light is. If the light is red, you will then stop. You can't just stop at every color you see. You're causing accidents. This is worse than I thought, people. It just terrifies me to think that you'll all one day be on the road. We need to move on. We are now going to simulate a real-life driving experience. Can I get them on tip? No. You may either speak or cut pole. Grab a chair. Could you grab mine too? I'm not as young as I used to be.
Creek. Sit. Click.
Now remember, everyone. Click it or tick it.
Like this?
Exactly. Now, let's hit the road.
Room, room?
I'm glad to see there's at least one person here who paid attention to the late Mr. Stegley.
He's dead?
What now? Now, as you may or may not have noticed, she has her hands on the tended to formation. That's perfect. You'll also notice that.
What?
What?
What were you thinking?
What did I do?
What did you do? You ran right through that red light and hit that truck.
You didn't tell me there was a red light.
Let me tell you something. There isn't always going to be someone in the car to tell you if there's a red light or not.
The car.
Last warning, hand over your bullets or no one clerk, such as myself, can easily outwit
a dumb robber.
This concludes our lesson today. I'd highly rather go to the store. Tomorrow we will be learning of how to rob a pet store without getting bitten. Any questions? Yes.
What does this have to do with biology?
virtually nothing.
Then why are you teaching it in the biology class?
Is this room 403?
401.
How embarrassing. I have to go.
You see, class, that was the wrong way to teach a class to rob a donut store. If you don't come in with a strong lesson plan, then a smart student can easily outwit you and send you running out the door. Any questions? Yes.
Can we leave now?
You didn't like my lesson?
No.
Okay.
You see, class, this is the wrong way to teach a class, the wrong way to teach a class, the wrong way of how to rob a donut store. If you don't come in emotionally stable.
Oh, shut up! Math class, today's real lesson is how to teach, has had a mess in people's minds. As you can see, we have just had three.
Well, you're the one who came here.
That's because you said anything. I could have taken
Well, you're wasting your time arguing with me.
Shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You.
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 Why don't you?
Why don't you?
Why don't you?
Why don't you?
You shut up.
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 You.
Why don't you?
Why don't you?
Why don't you? I'd give anything for this one kiss from Judy Johnson. Except my soul!
Anything. Even your soul.
I just said anything except my soul!
Well, you mumbled that last part. Don't. Don't mumble.
And not did too. And not did tuner shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You.
You shut up.
Why don't you?
Why don't you?
You.
You.
You are ridiculous.
I'd do anything for just one kiss from Judy Johnson.
Anything, even your soul.
For you, Judy Johnson? Yes!
Oh, come on! That's not even fair!
I thought you left.
Well, I did it! I was hiding behind this desk the entire time!
Excuse me, I was behind this desk, and I didn't see any devil.
What are you talking about? I said hi!
Did not! You were all acting like I wasn't back there the entire time.
Aha! So you did see me, you liar!
Leave her alone, dude!
Fine! I'll go find another kid to bother!
Save me from the devil.
And I didn't even have to give you up my soul.
So, do you want to, like, start a relationship or something?
Nope. I just wanted that one kiss. Now, if you excuse me,
Dave tried to disappear like the devil, but instead fell and broke his arm.
Ow!
And thus ends one of the greatest romances in American history.
I hate you!
what? You're gonna go talk to her?
She heard every line of the book. Jason, you don't have the best history of... Jason!
Hey, I couldn't help but notice you. Can I get a Diet Pepsi?
I don't work here.
I know. Wait. I mean, I know you don't work here because... Crap!
What are you doing?
Guys, I just got a little jumbled up there.
I'm fine.
That was not fine.
What do you mean? It was perfectly fine. You know what? I'm gonna head back in.
Oh, by the way, Jason, I don't think that's Diet Pepsi.
Yeah. I'm terribly sorry about that. What I meant to say was, I work here, and you order a Diet Pepsi.
If you work here, then how can I sort you with your friends over there when I first walked in?
That was not me. That was that guy.
The gorilla?
The gorilla.
Well, I never ordered a Diet Pepsi.
You didn't? These things aren't cheap, you know.
Well, I'll take it.
Okie dokie. Oh, only $25.
$25? For a Diet Pepsi?
$25. For a Diet Pepsi. Crap!
What are you doing?
You have to stop.
Guys, I think everything's going really well.
Everything's not going really well because you keep coming here and hiding behind the table.
Dude, everything's going great because I keep coming back here and hiding behind the table.
Touché. Wait, touché? That made no sense.
Dude, let me assure you, that made plenty of sense. Crap!
guarantee you, you are now part of a very elite squad.
What do you mean when we made the team? I thought these were tryouts.
Tryouts? What do you think this is? The Miss America Beauty Pageant?
But there's too many players for the team.
And who do you think you are? The judge of the Miss America Beauty Pageant? All right.
No,
let's get started, everyone. Now, who can tell me what this is?
That's a football coach.
Wrong! I am a football coach. This is a football. My gosh! Give me 20. Who are you? And what's that?
This is a football.
No, this is a football.
No, this is.
No, this is.
No, this is.
Your voice is funny. What state are you from?
England.
All right, congratulations, you're on the team. What is he doing?
That's a push-up, coach.
That is not a push-up, coach. That is your teammate. I will not have you assigning positions on this team. Got it? Now, does anyone else here think that they're the coach?
Coach?
No, you are not the coach. I am the coach. No. Yes.
No.
Yes.
No lie.
Yes.
No coach.
So I'm no coach? Listen here. You're no coach. The only reason you're on this team today is because you showed up. If you hadn't showed up, I would have cut you so fast.
That doesn't make any sense.
Ah, my goodness. It's day one, people. Day one. And you're all showboating around like it's the talent portion of the Miss America Beauty Pageant. Let me assure you, it is not.
Yes, coach.
All right, then. You five, I want you to give me 20.
We don't understand what you mean by that.
My goodness, sir. What do you think this is, the Miss America Beauty Pageant? And it's like we don't speak the same language, but we're from the same state.
Coach, that's exactly what it is.
All right. I want you five to run down the track. I want you to sprint. Go to those flower bushes over there and pluck 20 flowers. Now, give me 20.
What?
Give me 20. Move, move. The way we're going to win this shit is through discipline. Discipline is formed through habit, and habit is formed through intense drills. Now, you five, line up. Wait, what's this? What kind of posture is that? Sit up straight, up straight. Now, put your shoulders back, head up. Okay. Raise your left hand. Push your other arm in the crayons. The left hand should be a little bit lower. Face left. Now, wave that hand. Wave it. Good. Like this. Good. My gosh! Would it kill you two to smile?
Smile?
Yes. Smile. Now do it. Good. Now put a knee forward. Slightly forward.
Not to be rude, but what does this have to do with football, coach?
This doesn't have anything to do with being a football coach. This has to do with being a football player. Get your minds off me and focus on yourselves. My gosh, this ain't the evening wear portion of the Miss America Beauty Pageant.
But...
What in the blue blazes took you so long?
The stems were freaky.
Man, would you? And go hand those flowers off in those cradles.
Coach, this is embarrassing, Coach.
I'm an embarrassment now, am I?
No, it just, it makes me feel like a woman.
A woman? This is a man's team, son. If you want to be on a team of women, you go join the Miss America Beauty Pageant. Oh, my goodness. Take it, everyone, take it. I understand it's our first day together, and being a team is something that takes time. So, I'm gonna do something a little bit more simple. You, stand up. What's your name?
Charlie Coach.
Charlie Coach? I'm not a Charlie Coach.
That sounds familiar.
Well, Charlie Coach, I want you to tell me what talent you have.
I'm really good at knocking guys over.
What kind of talent is that?
I'm really fast. I'm a fast runner. I run fast.
Let me tell you something, son. There's only so much room to run.
I know.
Well, keep going. What other talents you got?
Oh, I've got a good arm.
There you go, that's it, son. Now, I want you to show me what you can do with this. What are you doing?
You told me to throw it!
I told you to show me what you can do with it. That was our last baton. Look how far you threw that. It's gone.
Coach, what does any of this have to do with football?
Yeah.
Oh, so we got a hot shot on the team now, do we? You stand up. Let's see how great you really are. Okay, get this. We're going to go up against Central. Get this. There's less than 30 seconds on the clock. You're the quarterback. Central's up on us 20-14. Answer me one question. If you had one wish, what would it be?
You're on the goal line for a game-winning touchdown, Coach.
Wrong! World peace! The answer, if you had one wish, what would it be, is always world peace. My gosh, what a bunch of amateurs we have here. What do you think this is? The Miss America Beauty Pageant?
Oh, right, that's it. I'm sick of this. You keep telling us that this isn't the Miss America Beauty Pageant, but all of the drills you keep having us doing,
the smiling, the waving, the flowers, the baton twirling, the question and answer period,
all seem to be in preparation for the Miss America Beauty Pageant.
Yeah!
Guys, hear me out. Years ago, I used to be on this team. We were state champions. We beat Central every year. We haven't beaten Central in over a decade. The smiling and waving, those are thrills of concentration. The baton twirling, yeah, power's great, but it won't get you anywhere without control. The question and answer period, I just want to make sure you have your priorities in order.
Touché.
So, if I have been demeaning or unreasonable, that is because I want to win. Now, does anyone else here want to win?
Yeah!
Does anyone else here want to beat Central?
Yeah!
Does anyone else want to take home state championship?
Yeah!
Put these on! Ah!
that turned on red.
But that's a woman's bikini top.
Yeah!
No!
I am not wearing a woman's bikini top!
What? Do you think it's demeaning?
No!
Well, you better get over your contemporary progressive views and suck it up, buttercup!
All right, that's it. I don't know what this is, but it ain't football. I'm out.
Me too!
Me too!
Fine! Go ahead and quit. You're a bunch of losers anyway. You'll never know what it's like to achieve true football glory.
Looks like your team forfeits another season, Coach.
Go away!
Your team will never be my voice from Central.
Oh yeah?
Oh wait, where is your team?
We didn't have practice today.
But the poster says football tryouts. Today.
It was banned! And your team is so great! Missed 10 years in a row.
Let me just call them out a minute. I'm gonna take the field, boys!
Are they wearing?
Woman's bikini tops.
No!
That state championship trophy is all mine.
Yeah!
Good idea.
that undermines the point that this is an emergency.
That, and the fact that in order to pass a measure like that, we would likely need a general student body vote.
Ooh, good idea! All in favor?
Aye!
To the hall!
Go!
3 days later.
I'm pleased to announce that the measure to allow medical meetings in emergency situations has passed.
Hear, hear!
Yay!
I would like to take the next few moments to acknowledge the following people.
We don't have time. We've already wasted 3 days voting.
Wasted? 3 days?
You know, a lot of people went to a lot of trouble to resolve the measures. You spearheaded it.
Pay careful to pay attention. You have to pay attention.
It'll only take a moment. Proceed. For the passing measure 3.1459, I would like to acknowledge the following people.
Come on.
Madam Secretary, for your swiftness in construction of an emergency ballot.
My pleasure.
Madam Treasurer, for your get out and vote campaign. Thanks to you, we have the largest non-general student body vote this school has ever seen. 8 votes!
Outstanding!
And we must recognize our treasurer again for her boldness. I commend you for walking right up to the principal and demanding a vote be held this week.
He kept telling me how now was a good time and I shouldn't interrupt him while he's trying to break up a school fight.
It's never a good time with him.
Yes, well, I finally convinced him that democracy rises above the common school brawl.
Hear, hear. That fist fight lasted for hours. But the political battle was won in moments, thanks to you.
Yep. Well, and let us not forget your efforts, Mr. Vice President. If you hadn't mailed out those absentee ballots to the students who were absent, their voices, they might not have been heard.
Yes. And none of them mailed those ballots back. People, please.
I am so proud. So proud of the student government today. We need to celebrate.
Ooh, I like the sound of that.
To the coffee shop!
Yay!
The next day...
How's everyone feeling today?
The question is, how are you feeling?
Man, I had a lot of coffee.
Me too. I had, like, no sleep.
Me either!
I didn't either. You know why? Because this school stands.
You know, it really wouldn't be fair to the students we represent to vote on a tired mind.
No, it isn't.
What?
I move that we all go home and get some rest.
Second.
And then we can talk to this issue tomorrow with fresh minds.
All in favor?
No.
See you, Jason.
No.
The next day. How's everyone feeling today?
Oh, that's better.
Lovely. Now, Jason.
What?
The meeting.
Oh! Well.
Okay, I'm pleased to announce that this minuteless emergency meeting, is now underway.
Great! Now, as you all may or may not have noticed.
What is it?
Oh, nothing.
People, we don't have time.
No, what is it?
Well, it's just that the whole minuteless part is very troubling. I know we voted to allow it in emergency situations. It's just that...
It's just that what?
Well, it's just that... do we define an emergency? What if we go through this entire meeting and figure out that it wasn't an emergency at all? We would have just violated the rights of the entire student body!
Let me assure you, this is an emergency. A huge emergency.
Okay, let's talk, not growl. How do we define an emergency?
Something that needs to be discussed immediately, like this.
But that's just it. That's too vague. We really
an emergency, and then approve it. That wouldn't be right. We'd need approval through a general student body vote.
True. All in favor?
Aye.
To the poll.
You put that paw down.
What?
Nothing. Wait.
Another 5 days later.
It's been another tough battle, but we did it!
Yes, congratulations to all. This is a victory indeed.
Madam Secretary, you really came through with an impressive turnout.
Only 5 votes.
Yes, but at one point we had like 0 votes. Can you imagine if we put this issue up for a resolve and we got like 0 votes? That'd be as bad as getting mauled by a tiger.
That would indeed be that bad.
Jason, pay attention.
What?
How dare you not pay attention? This is an emergency meeting that you wanted to have.
Stripey work.
You need to pay attention.
You know what? I think we all deserve another celebration.
To the coffee shop!
Huzzah!
What? Where?
Would you like to come?
No! No, I'm not getting coffee with you people.
You're lost.
Do you hate? Of course not.
Wait a minute. How do you know if you have it or not when I haven't even said what the product is?
All right, Dow, we have it. We don't have much of anything here.
Not much of anything. This is one of the largest stores in the area.
Yes, well, it's a lot smaller than it looks. Please, leave me alone.
Look, I'll leave you alone if you answer my one question. Where is that tooth you had in your hand?
I don't know.
Well, could you find someone who does know? Why not?
Well, one, because I don't want to. Two, I don't think we even carry soup here.
Yes, you do. I saw it in your head.
Well, I guess lesson learned here is don't believe everything you read.
That's it. Go get your manager. I want to complain.
Fine. Jeez. Rude. He's not here right now.
What do you mean he's not here? You didn't even
look. Yes, I did.
How could you have? You were only gone for a second.
Yes, well, in that second, I ran through the entire store at the speed of light, searching from top to bottom.
That's it. I've given you until the count of 10 to go get your manager, or I'm calling your district manager.
Fine.
You wrinkly old history teacher? It's biology. First, I get up early in the morning to go deal with some ratty students. Then, a giant frog goes into my classroom. Then, they don't even have my soup. What is wrong with this town?
Hello! I am the...
Yes, one of your... You're not the manager. Yes, I... You're that pesky kid.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Ow!
Now go get your manager.
You don't have a manager. Ow! That really hurt, lady.
That's it. I am leaving, and I am never shopping here again.
Please.
It's my soup. I guess I'll stay.
Hey!
Do you need help?
Thank you so much for joining me today.
Oh, how could we not? Our little Charlie being inducted into the National Honor Society.
I'm afraid you must have misread my message. Charlie's not being inducted into the National Honor Society.
See, honey? I told you he didn't say the National Honor Society. He said the Dead Poets Society.
You didn't even hear the message, dear.
I'm afraid we don't even have a Dead Poets Society. Nor is he going into the National Honor Society. The reason I called you here today is because Charlie is on the brink of failing out of school.
But his son, he's got nothing but A's.
Charlie's got nothing but S, Mr. Johansson.
But his teachers, they've had nothing but wonderful things to say about him.
Charlie's teachers have had nothing but terrible things to say. I'm not sure where you're coming up with this.
Well, I don't know where you're coming up with our son being a bad student.
I'm not coming up with this, Mr. Johansson. It's true. Charlie only pays attention half of the time to his classes. The other half, he just makes it all up.
I find all this hard to believe.
Oh, I was afraid you were going to say that. So I took the liberty of asking our student theater department to come perform Charlie's latest book report. Troop, if you'll come out, please. Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, students, if you will.
Dr. Jekyll stared at himself in the mirror, in horror. He could feel the potion running through him. The transformation was underway.
You're a weak man, Dr. Jekyll. A weak man. I'll take it from here.
A weak man, am I?
Okay, Mr. Hyde. What are you implying?
Oh, nothing.
Then why did you just emphasize the word Mr.?
No reason.
You don't think I have what it takes to be a doctor?
Quite frankly, let me think about that. No.
Yeah? I'll show you.
And with that, Mr. Hyde hit the books. He spent countless hours studying until finally it was graduation day.
This is well deserved, Mr. Hyde. Well deserved indeed.
What do you mean, Mr. Hyde? It's Dr. Hyde now.
Nope, sorry. This is beauty school.
Dang it!
What of it? And it speaks English. Seems like something you would mention to
finish your son's history report on the invention of the light bulb.
Can I borrow that?
Sure.
The year was 1879. A young Thomas Edison was hard at work, working on an invention that would change the way the world sees. Kaleidoscopic glasses. However, it was getting dark, and Edison was having trouble seeing himself.
Ah! That's the third match I burnt myself with this year!
That's ridiculous, sir.
Shut up, Leon! We're scrapping the kaleidoscopic glasses for now, and we're working on something that prevents people from burning themselves. Fireproof glass.
Sir, if I could, the glass you speak of already exists. What if we could build a contraption to do away with matches altogether?
Do away with matches? Have you gone mad? I'm calling the assignment. But wait! What if there were a way for me to call the asylum without leaving the lab?
Sir, again if I could. No such invention exists.
That's it!
So Edison and his assistant went to work, building a contraption very similar to the modern telephone. They then laid connecting cables connecting the lab to the asylum.
All right, this is it, the moment of truth. I will call for the asylum and they will take you away without leaving the lab. Quiet, Leo.
Unfortunately for Edison, the doctors at the asylum had no idea what was making that ringing noise. So they smashed the device with a hammer.
Darn it! No answer. Fine, I'll refill you your stupid idea instead.
3 weeks later, the light bulb was invented. Somehow. And thus ends this important chapter in America.
The trombone? That was your son's history report.
I have to agree with my husband. I mean, should my son have gone for the 2-point conversion? Maybe not, but we can armchair quarterback all day long, Principal Swanson.
What?
I think my wife is trying to be safe, Principal Swanson. We hear you loud and clear. Our son shouldn't be wearing a cape to school. We'll talk to him immediately.
Okay. You know what? You're right. It isn't Charlie's fault at all. It's your fault. The reason that Charlie doesn't pay attention to anything his teachers say is because he's learning from you two. You haven't even listened this entire time. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Wow.